So the best possible thing is for a visitor to be able to have a one-on-one experience with someone with deep knowledge of the park. And it can create the most meaningful connections. Unfortunately, it's not always possible for there to be people with deep knowledge everywhere in the park. And that's where we come in. We are the exhibits shop. So there are 9 of us that service 89 parks, and we run typically 50 to 70 projects per year. They range in size from a handful of signs all the way up to a large visitor center or nature center and everything in between.
We make these other signs visitor orientation panels, VOPs, and they have the big red arrow on them. You are here. So that's the running joke. And then my brother-in-law said, we'd be lost without you.
What we can do is to tell the story of the people who built the walls.
I supervise 3 teams. We have the interpretive planners who research and write content for our projects and also project manage those projects.
We identify interpretive themes. We write content, find pictures, research, background.
And then I have a team of graphic designers, and they do all the design work.
The photograph that I was told about that they wanted to put in from the Austin History Center. It's really fun to bring an idea to life.
And then I have a team of fabricators and installers that make exhibits, interior exhibits, exterior exhibits, furniture, and they also drive all over Texas and dig the holes and put the things in the ground. Over the 14 years that I've been here, we have put literally thousands of signs out in parks. And most of those signs each have 2 holes. If you've ever dug a hole in Texas, you know that it is serious business. Of those, probably 10,000 holes that we have put in Texas, Tom has probably dug 9,000 of them. And he has been to every single park at least twice.
Yes, I have. At least twice.
He's put more miles on vehicles than most of us combined. Everyone is super creative, and we bring all those skills and labor together to make whatever we think is gonna serve the stories of the park the best. Cool. So we take that job really seriously. And some topics are more challenging to talk about than others.
One of the very special things about McKinney as a park is that it has some very sensitive history.
Part of the history here is enslavement. Thomas McKinney is a well-known, Texas pioneer, and like many of his contemporaries, was an ardent slave owner.
We're just trying to give facts about a space. And sometimes it's not the best of news. It isn't the prettiest story.
We try to tell the stories that relate to all Texans. Telling the stories of enslaved people, of segregation, other sorts of difficult topics that were maybe at one time in the past more avoided. We try to take those head on when they're appropriate in our parks.
We're all an equal part in this story, and I think excluding some stories and lifting up other stories doesn't do a great service to our state and to the legacy of Texas that I think we're all really proud of.
Having that ability because of what we do is phenomenal. We're so lucky that we get to do that.
And so we are in a very privileged position to be able to be so central to the mission of Texas Parks and Wildlife in connecting people to the resources.
Connecting people to the park, to the land, the animals, the plants, the history is really what it's all about for us. Telling those stories and helping more people learn them, at least until we can get back to the park and tell another one.